G'day. In this COSTAR video, we're going to show you one of the latest features in COSTAR, which is the COSTAR Registration Checker. This integration provides you with the peace of mind and knowledge that the vehicle that you or your staff members are driving is fully registered and legally safe to drive. Before we get started in the actual use of it, we need to ensure that it's switched on, and one of the requirements in the setup is that you need to be registered and configured for the use of the MDX. So if you're not currently receiving any electronic invoices from any of your suppliers, the chances are that you will need to contact our support desk and they will help get this step underway. If you're currently receiving these ASNs, then follow the next instructions and we will guide you through configuring your system for the Rego Checker. First of all, we go down to Settings and then into Order Entry Options, Integration 2, and configure Microhouse Integration Providers. On that screen, there comes up, there's a field that here called Is Registration Fields on Vehicles. If that's not flagged, then give that a tick, and that will enable us to then view the registration check in the menu on the left. Below that menu item, we've got the integration, which in turn shows the number of branches that we have in our COSTAR database, and we can choose which branches we want to turn the integration on or off for. In this instance, I'm configuring it for branch one, so I double click on that branch and I'm presented with the registration check service agreement. As we're accessing a third party national database that contains vehicle information and registration status of all vehicles in Australia. There is a fee involved of 50 cents plus GST per lookup, and as a result, we need to confirm that we agree with the terms and conditions provided. So we tick the enable integration type, enter our full name and email address, and confirm that we agree with the terms and conditions. Once we hit accept and proceed, it returns us back to our screen listing our branches. And we can see that for branch one, this particular integration is now in use. So we click on back and back again, and we return to our main COSTAR menu. Once we've logged back into COSTAR, we're able to go to our repair order and create a new repair order. We can go straight across to the registration field and type the rego details as they're presented. When I search on that, it lets me know the customer vehicle is not in my own internal COSTAR database. So what I can do now is search that registration plate in the National Registration Database by going to Vehicle Details. We can see that the registration details have come across and we nominate what state that plate belongs to. We then check the registration status. So at this point, it's asking us to confirm the details that we're going to be checking and lets us know that once we hit that perform check button down further, it's going to incur the fee of the 50 cents plus GST per check. And so we click on perform check and it brings back and lets us know that the vehicle is registered until the 22nd of the 11th, 2019. So I can see that it brings back the year, make, model, color, and VIN of that particular vehicle associated with that rego plate, and I can accept or choose which fields I want to keep. And back on our screen here, we can see that it's brought across those details as presented by the registration database, along with the date the registration is due for that vehicle. I can go back out of there and put in the appropriate details of the owner as per normal. So that's what we can do with the brand new vehicle. If the vehicle has been in before, then we can bring that vehicle in and do a search on that particular registration. I can check the registration status again by going into the vehicle details, but because the COSTAR holds when that rego is due, I know that I do not have to do another rego check. So therefore, there's no need for me to go in and check that rego again. In the instance where a registration date has expired and that vehicle comes into our store, I am alerted to this when again I type in that registration. Over here, the alerts button is flashing, letting me know that there's something that needs my attention. When I click on the alerts, I'm able to navigate to my vehicle registration, and it lets me know that the registration was due on the 11th of the 3rd and overdue by 36 days. So it could very well have been paid by now. So this is where I would do a secondary check to ensure that my vehicle is registered and my staff are not driving unregistered vehicles. So I do the check and it goes off and lets me know that this vehicle is still unregistered. So I would then have that discussion with the client as to the best way to proceed. Thank you for your time. Certainly, if you have any questions in relation to this, please contact our support desk and we will be more than happy to help you out. To keep a track of upcoming features in COSTAR, make sure you subscribe to our channel and check us out on Facebook and LinkedIn. Thanks, and we'll see you in the next video installment.